It was a rainy morning on the island of Sodor. Edward had just woken up.
Good morning.
Everyone's awake. Alright, what time is it? 6 a.m.?
Oh, we better get waking.
Oh, we better go shunt. Alright. Okay, what are they laughing about? Look at him strain.
He's weak.
Come on, get moving. You see him straining? Positively painful.
You know, James, I would say that, but you know, only the stupid Williams would say that. It's blatantly obvious.
I hate you, Henry. Would you guys just, like, shut up? He put more effort into this training more than you guys would ever do. Okay, yeah. It's despicable, disgraceful, and disgusting. Okay, you're true there, Donnie. Suppose we can agree on something. Yes.
Edward, dear lad, scrap yourself. You have no use. The others were in shock by what Gordon had said.
Huh?
Toodaloo, nerds, he said. While the others were in utter shock, Edward suddenly...
Yes, I've done it, I've done it. Goodbye, lads. I'll see you tonight. Bye, Edward.
The weather was starting to roughen up when Edward left. He didn't realize that would soon lead to his downfall.
As Edward pulled into the station, he saw the two twin engines, Bill and Ben. Hello, you two.
Hi, Edward.
Hi, Edward.
You know what to do?
Yep, just Classic Branch Line Express.
Break Van Express, but same thing.
Bye, Edward.
Bye, you two. The two engines excitedly ran into the clay pits.
Yippee, we get to show them all over the place.
Now listen here, young scallywags. Shut up, Fergus.
I'd never.
The two backed them down into a side.
Alrighty. What should we tell them first? Ooh, go into the mine. Okay.
I showed them the mine shaft. They showed them a derailed engine.
Get me off this rail. Now.
They showed them where they got their trucks and how to fill them. And Ben even managed to scare them.
Bill! Got him.
So soon it was time for them to leave. As I ran up the slope that led to the clay pits.
Trickety trot, don't dawdle,
they sang.
We won't.
Trundled the breakdance behind them. As they thundered down the line. They ran past Trevor's field.
Hi, Trevor.
Oh, hello, Rudy.
And reversed through Sudbury.
Hello.
You two okay?
Yeah. Oh, it's rain, though.
I understand. Well, I must be off soon. It was nice getting to chat with you two. I will see you two tomorrow. With a blow of his whistle, Edward left the station.
Edward was passing by the old castle whenever he felt a sharp pain.
Ugh!
Driver, whenever we get to the next station, could you check that out, please?
Indeed, Edward.
Oh, there it is again! Ugh! Feels like a... Oh, God, driver! Oh, my side rock! It's ripping! Bring it to a stop! Oh God! What happened?
Edward's driver quickly got out and assessed the damage. Your crank pin, old boy, it's gone straight through you. There's only one way you can do. If you want to continue with this train, we're gonna have to take off your crank pin and make it run like an old single. But we'll get there or bust. That's what I'm gonna say. We will not lose this train to the roads. Edward struggled to pull the train.
Come on. Come on. Get moving. Come on, just please. Ugh, I can't.
But then, his driver had an idea.
Wait a minute, Edward. What if we try what you do with the truck?
We uncouple all of them, and then we stretch the chain. That way, whenever you get the first one moving, that one will help the second, and then that one will help the third. Edward put it to the test. And as he tried to set off, the first coach helped the second, and the second helped the third, and so on down the train, as Edward managed to leave.
Yes! Oh, God, this hurts! Come on, driver. Shovel some more coal. Yeah, we're doing it!
The journey was off again. The passengers were cheering out of their coaches.
Come on, old boy! We can get to Knapford in time. Oh, I just hope we can.
Edward was almost at the station when there was a loud crank.
Oh, God, driver. Oh, what the... I don't know, but just keep up. Oh,
yes. We're here. That's where an old headlamp. Oh, Gordon. Hello, Big City Engine.
Fine. Didn't want to be in that video anyway.